We were going to unbox this ASUS Prime B660MA motherboard, but decided to take a different approach. One reason is we recently unboxed and reviewed this ASUS Prime B550MA, and there's only a few small differences between the two motherboards. The main difference is the 660 board is socketed for an LGA 1700, and it has a USB-C front header port. That's pretty much the only difference. Other reason why is because we had to use a 12th gen i3 to post into the BIOS to update it, as we're installing a 13th gen i3 in the completed build. Keep this in mind if you're looking at purchasing this board. A 13th gen processor will not work out of the box. So at the time of this video, the 12th gen i3 is $89.99 on Amazon, and the 13th gen i3 is $99 on Amazon. So what I want to show today is if the 13th gen i3 is worth the $10 extra. We are actually giving this computer away at a local event here in a couple weeks. Those of you watching for this purpose, we will show you how it performs in games as well. Today's video is sponsored by Silkland, which offers pretty much any type of VGA cable you could ask for. They are VESA certified, real high quality, and most of all, affordable. Check them out, linked in the description below. Before we start testing, let's install the 13th gen i3. Here's a tip on how I like to clean off old thermal paste. I use these BioPure electronic wipes that are safe to use on CPUs. It works great and easy cleanup. I follow that with a low-lint static-free cloth to remove any excess residue from the alcohol. I'll throw a link down in the description. Both CPU tests were conducted with ThermalRite TF7 we received with the SI100 CPU cooler. Now to apply the thermal paste. Maybe I'll do a debate in future content. After that, it boots right up into the BIOS, we reapply the XMP, and then, anytime I'm swapping hardware out, I go into Device Manager, click View, show hidden devices, then look for the old components no longer used. In this case, we have the 12100F that is disabled but not necessary. I remove those to prevent any anomalies, probably doesn't matter, but I sleep better at night knowing those are gone. Now for some basics. Not only are both processors close in price, but also in performance. I'm curious to see if we will even notice a difference here. The 200 MHz boost increase on the 13th gen may be marginal but worth it. Let's start off with PC Mark to gather some data. So our 12th gen baseline went smooth and gave us some scores to go off of. And here's the 13th gen with the annotated difference. A hair over 5%, it's not all that exciting, but still worth noting. We also ran a Cinebench R23 benchmark and we ended up with a 4.7% performance increase on the 13th gen. To briefly touch on thermals, both sit very nice at idle, and during the R23 run, both were in the low 50s. The 13th gen is a hair warmer because it runs just a hair more watts. Now let's run a Firestrike benchmark. I'm speeding things up so that we can get to the scores and some estimated game performance. The numbers we pull are just as it says, an estimate, not exact. As for the scores, they're pretty much the same, with the 13th gen gaining a slight lead. Battlefield 5, 1440p, 75fps, 140fps at 1080p. Apex Legends, 85fps, 1440p, 140 at 1080p. GTA 5, 1440p, 50fps, 165, 1080p. Fortnite, 1440p, 45fps. 1080p, the 13th gen, 220, and 12th gen, 215. And Red Dead Redemption, 1440p, 30fps, 85 at 1080p. Now let's run a Forza Horizon 5 benchmark. I'm fast forwarding through this one as well because so far the difference is underwhelming, but I hope this helps someone out there make an informed decision when deciding on these two chips. Either way, smash that subscribe button for more. You never know what hardware we'll test next. Sometimes we don't even know. Moving on to the results. Awesome graph here, but let's see the 12th gen. Pretty much the same, honestly. 2fps is marginal. How about 1080p? 1fps difference? Wow. What about some gameplay? So here we are looking at the same difference pretty much. I can pause several frames here and show each one of these outperform each other ever so slightly. So I think we have all the data we need to make a conclusion. Real quick though, let's take a look at the Cyberpunk benchmark results. At 1440p, the 13th gen pulled about 0.4 FPS more. At 1080p, even closer, but interesting to see the 12th gen pull over 10 max FPS. Now for my conclusion, if the 13th gen i3 is worth the 10 extra bucks. Based off the PC Mark test and the R23, yes. It has a slight edge on single and multi-core processing that would be useful in day-to-day tasks. And for 10 extra bucks, sure, why not? Now, if you're on a strict budget and you're building strictly for gaming, then no. We saw little to no difference in the gaming tests that we did today. And even if you're on a budget and you're looking to shave $10 off, then this is the place to start. Now, for this specific combination that we use today, I think the i3 works really well with the 2070. Although this GPU is older technology, it still performs very well in games and slightly outperforms the 3060. It'll probably outperform the 4050 the way things are going. Anyways, I appreciate y'all watching this video, and if you're going to be at our local giveaway in a couple weeks, if you know, you know, then I can't wait to see y'all and give this away to one of you lucky winners. Other than that, we hope to see you next time and have a wonderful day.